Welcome friends, if pregnant, you need immediate COVID-19 vaccine. COVID-19 vaccine protects pregnant mothers, prevents maternal death, stillbirth, and premature delivery, gives immunity to the infants. Nature 601, 308 to 309 pages of 2022. More results are pouring in, showing protection afforded by COVID-19 vaccine to pregnant women. Yet in the US, Center for Disease Control and Prevention calculates that only 40% pregnant mothers are vaccinated till 1st of January 2022. Globally too, the percentage of vaccination among this group remains the same. When COVID vaccines were first administered to the public in late 2020, little was known about its effect on pregnant women as they were not represented in clinical trials. It left pregnant women to take their own decision, completely ignorant and anxious of how it may affect their growing fetuses. Alison Cahill, specialist in maternal fetal medicine in Dell Medical School, Austin, Texas, says that all of her critically ill pregnant mothers refused to be vaccinated at that time. Now the researchers possess solid data. It shows that the risk of COVID-19 during pregnancy, including maternal death, stillbirth, and premature delivery, far outweigh the risk of being vaccinated. It also shows that the antibodies pass through breast milk of vaccinated mothers and provide immunity to the infants, at least for the first 6 months. The vaccination needs to be done before 20 weeks of pregnancy. The threats posed by COVID-19 during pregnancy was never in doubt for the following reasons. 1. Pregnant mother's body will suppress certain parts of immune system to tolerate a growing fetus. 2. The blood volume will expand considerably, which will put strain on the cardiovascular system. And 3. The lung capacity will be reduced as the growing uterus pushes up the diaphragm. A viral infection like COVID-19 at this juncture will potentially be life-threatening, observes Dr. Andrea Edlow, a maternal fetal medicine specialist at Harvard Medical School and Massachusetts General Hospital in Boston. A review of study of about 870,000 females who gave birth in nearly 500 medical centers in the US for the 1 year period between 1st of March 2020 and 28th February 2021 showed that the pregnant women diagnosed with COVID-19 were 15 times more likely to die and 14 times more likely to be intubated, that is, inserting a tube through the mouth or nose down the trachea for breathing, than pregnant women without COVID-19 infection. The affected were also 22 times more likely to be having premature delivery, Nature 601, 308 to 309 of 2022. This data compelled the CDC to change its earlier stand of leaving decision about vaccination to the pregnant women and their attending doctors, and recommended pregnant women to receive a vaccine. At the time of the onslaught of October 2021, critically ill COVID-19 patients were 20% unvaccinated pregnant women. In the same period of time, CDC's morbidity and mortality weekly report, 1642-1645 pages of 2021, found that the risk of stillbirth was 2.7 times and maternal mortality 5 times higher among pregnant COVID-19 infected women. For Omicron variant, no data is available as it emerged by November 2021. The number of pregnant women admitted in the U.S. hospitals was 25,000, and 250 of them died by the end of 2021. At that period, out of the 827 who gave birth to children after receiving the vaccine, the rate of stillbirth, maternal death, and premature delivery were comparably the same as that of pre-COVID time. After the second vaccine, pregnant women acquired more resistance to disease than the unvaccinated, report at AOC et al. In Science Translational Medicine 13 of 2021. Several studies show that the vaccinated pregnant mothers transferred their antibodies to the child through placenta during pregnancy. In Nature 594, pages 492-494 of 2021, Dr. Molly Siegel, obstetrician at Massachusetts General Hospital, Boston, observes that vaccines do not pass through breast milk, but antibodies do. Dr. Stephanie Goh, perinatologist at University of California, San Francisco, holds the same view. Dr. Catherine Gray, a specialist in maternal fetal medicine at Brigham Women's Hospital, and her team found that COVID vaccine on 131 lactating mothers produced same antibody response as did those who were not lactating. This shows that the vaccine is just as beneficial for breastfeeding mothers as others. Dr. Golan Y. et al. In a preprint in MedRx for agrees with this. CDC advised nursing mothers against receiving yellow fever vaccine, which involves live weakened form of viruses, because of a very negligible chance that the infection may pass to the infant. Because of that, some pharmacists and vaccine administrators have been urging nursing mothers to discard their breast milk after they have been vaccinated. This shows clear ignorance and lack of understanding, says an immunologist at the University of Rochester, New York, Dr. Kirsi Charvinian-Sepol. The messenger RNA vaccines are designed to break down quickly, that it would not leave the cell where it was injected. CDC and UK Joint Committee on Vaccination and Immunization support it. In the mother, immune cells called B lymphocytes or B cells continually produce antibodies. Once lactation begins, the mammary glands send out a chemical signal that draws these B cells into the breast, where they park in the glands and produce thousands of antibodies per second, ready to move in to breast milk in huge quantities. But unlike molecules from medications, coffee and alcoholic drinks, which are so small that they can pass into the breast milk on their own in their diluted levels, antibodies are too large to pass through. Instead, receptors on the surface of milk ducts grab the antibodies and package them in protective, fluid-filled bubbles that allow them to pass safely through the milk duct cells and into the milk on the other side. AOC and AlterG cell 184, pages 1486 to 1499 of 2021. This process is so magical, says the co-author of the paper, AlterG, an immunologist and virologist at Harvard Medical School in Boston. These antibodies do not pass into the body's bloodstream, but coat the mouth, throat, and gut before they are finally digested. These research works provide great results that will save pregnant mothers from the disastrous effects of COVID on them and the infants in their wombs. Take care. Bye till we meet again with another scientific research work explained in simple, understandable language. Please share, subscribe, and like my channel. Thank you all. Edwin Williams. Thank you.